So how important is a rain sock for your exposed filter intake? I learned a pretty important lesson. Let me tell you about it. How's it going, everybody? This is a pretty short one, so I'm gonna jump right in. I'm gonna give you the backstory on the rain sock and the lesson that I learned, and I'm also gonna cover the super simple installation of that rain sock. So if you wanna jump ahead to any other part of this video, you can use those links down in the video description. If you're not familiar with my setup, I have the Arlaness Monster Sucker intake installed on my Softail Street Bob FXBB with the 114 Stage 3 kit. Got that intake when I had the Stage 3 kit installed, and I've never really thought much about a rain sock. I do live in Florida, so occasionally I do get caught in a good rainstorm whenever I'm out riding, but I really didn't think much about it, and up to that point, I didn't have one. I was prepping the bike for another video where I pulled the crank sensor to check for sumping, and I knew there were rainstorms in the area, but I thought I could pick a route that would let me go around those storms and not have any problem with the rain. So I hit the road, hoping for the best, and about 30 minutes into the ride, I hit the heavy rain. Let me pause here for just a second and say thanks so much for stopping to check out this video. My name is Ron Chenal, and I like to tinker with motorcycle projects of all sizes and share those learnings with you along the way. So please be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and enable all notifications so you'll be alerted whenever I post a new video. Back to the rain sock. So I kept riding, not really even thinking about the intake or raindrops or anything like that. And then I went to accelerate and the bike stumbled. The bike never hesitates, it never stumbled. And as soon as it stumbled, I knew there was something going on with the rain and the intake. So I decided to turn around and head back home. Along the way, the bike stumbled again. And this time I could barely keep the bike running and actually pulled over on the side of the road and sort of nursed it along just to keep it running because I really didn't want the bike to cut off and then there might be problems getting it restarted. You know how that goes. Once I got it stabilized, I hit the road again because I was really close to the house at that point and I just wanted to get home and be done with this whole fiasco. I finally made it home. I went ahead with filming that video on removing the crank sensor and I also decided to go ahead and pull the intake bolts on that Arlaness intake because I also needed to do some follow-up checks on my other videos about crankcase venting and things like that. So here's the thing. I was out in the rain for like 30, 45 minutes. I don't think it was an hour. Well, it's kind of hard to see in this video because I wasn't trying to capture this when I was filming. I was trying to capture the removal of the intake itself. But if you look closely, when I pull this intake off, you'll see water pour out of the intake. Like I said, it's hard to see, but here it is again. Yeah, I was blown away. If I would have turned or accelerated or done something like that, that would have caused that water to get pulled up into the motor, that could have been disastrous. Needless to say, I ordered the rain sock that day. So here's a look at the rain sock. It's really simple. It's just a thin hydrophobic mesh that repels more water than it allows through. I'll have a link for the rain sock down in the video description if you want to check it out. Of course, I had to test it out to see if it does actually repel water. You can see even with a decent amount of flow, it does actually keep most of the water out. I'm guessing on the road more would get through because those raindrops would hit that mesh and break apart into finer particles and probably make it through that mesh. But then again, you're dealing with a mist and not heavy volume of water like you are when just those drops hit it. There's really not much to show or tell about the installation. Put it on the filter, center it up, good to go. It was surprisingly tight and I really had to work at getting it over the flange of the filter without causing any snags or tears or anything like that. But the nice part about being tight is once it's installed, it's very secure. From now on, I'll just keep that rain sock in my swing arm bag. And if a rainstorm hits, I'll just pull it out, slap it on and get back on the road. But knowing what I know now, if it's a heavy rainstorm, even if I have the rain sock, I'll probably just wait it out because I was really surprised at how much water got into that intake. Quick heads up on an upcoming video in the lineup. If you've seen my video series on crankcase venting and crankcase sumping, you may know that I'm working on a catch can solution that may just be the best of both worlds. It's a vacuum ported catch can modification that will allow for crankcase venting and an external breather mod while still maintaining vacuum in the crankcase. So that project is underway. Be on the lookout for that in the near future. Have you had a similar experience with your Monster Sucker intake? Or have you had any other problems with water incursion with your intake during a rainstorm or anything similar to that? Do you have a rain sock or are you thinking about getting one? Drop in a comment and let me know. Give me as many details as you can. I love to read about your experiences and your projects. I'm sure the rest of the community benefits from that as well. And don't hesitate to drop in any suggestions you have for future video topics also. And if you found this video informational or useful, please do hit the thumbs up button and share it with your friends. That really helps the channel out a lot It shows YouTube that you value the content, and I certainly appreciate it as well. And if you're new here to the channel, please do consider subscribing, hitting that notification bell, and enabling all notifications so you don't miss out whenever I post a new video. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy the ride. I'll see you next time.